action figure enthusiasts out there, JC here with another TNI news video. Now we've got a lot to cover today, so let's hop right into it. And for today's first story, it's going to be another one of those, what the f*** were they thinking about? So last week it was announced that a new Thundercats animated series would be coming to Cartoon Network. And of course that was exciting. You know, we've been waiting for something new for Thundercats for some time. We had the reboot series a couple years ago, which unfortunately did not last very long. While I thought it was a very cool cartoon, a number of fans seemed to think that the cartoon was a little too slow-paced and a little boring, and, you know, it just really obviously didn't bring in a new generation of Thundercat fans, and like I said, basically the plug was pulled pretty quickly on it. And with that, the toys, at the time Bandai America was doing an action figure line for Thundercats, and when the cartoon got canceled, that pretty much canceled the toys and everything. Now we're getting a new cartoon, but unfortunately, it looks like the studio is going in a totally different direction with it. And from a business standpoint, I guess I can see why they're making this choice. Essentially, they're trying to appeal to the young kids, maybe even more of a female demographic with this cartoon. So, you know, I think they're trying to widen the scope here, even though they're probably going to piss off most of the old-time Thundercat fans who grew up on the original cartoon. And definitely when this news announced that last week, many Thundercat fans were up in arms over it. For me personally, you know, it does nothing for me. Now, I guess I'll give you detail. So you can see from this art that is being done as what they call an action comedy. Again, very much in keeping with shows like Teen Titans Go. And as much as, you know, that's not really a show that appeals to me in any way, you know, you can see that that show has actually been around for many years. It, you know, has lasted for many years. So, you know, obviously it is definitely appealing to a number of people. So, again, I think that's the same demographic that show reaches that they're trying to reach with this show. Will it work? I don't know. To me, the biggest rub with this, cartoons come and go. There'll always be the original cartoon, so this doesn't ruin that in any way, in my opinion. But the biggest rub to me is that, you know, Mattel had started to do Thundercat figures with the Four Horsemen, which I thought were really good. Then they decided to stop essentially making action figures for collectors with Matty Collector and everything. And they handed the Masters of the Universe off to Super 7. Super 7 did want to continue the Thundercats line. But for whatever reason, at the time we didn't know, Warner Brothers essentially said no. Well, now it looks like likely the reason why they said no to Super 7 for doing Thundercat figures was because of this. And so essentially it's because of this cartoon, my guess is why we didn't get a continuation of those Four Horsemen Thundercat figures, which I think is very disappointing. Obviously, if the show is successful at all, I'm sure we will see some company pick up the toy license and do a range of toys for this new cartoon, which will obviously be done in this kind of comedic, cartoony style, which, again, really doesn't have much appeal to me. Hopefully, though, we will see, you know, maybe once the show gets established and, you know, a company does pick up the license, we will see a continuation of the classic Thundercat toys as well. Only time will tell. But definitely, like I said, to me, that's the biggest disappointment about all this news is it's probably because of this cartoon why we're not, you know, why Super 7 wasn't able to continue those Four Horsemen Thundercat figures. In other news, it was announced today by Boss Fight Studio that they would be doing a new line of collectible figures for Sam & Max. So Sam & Max is a pretty popular comic book series created by Steve Purcell. There's also video games for the characters and stuff that have been done. And Boss Fight Studio, who are known for doing a lot of 3¾-inch type figures, their own type figures, as well as like Bucky O'Hare. They've been doing brand new Bucky O'Hare figures, and those have been pretty successful. I suspect, even though we don't have any specific details on the Sam & Max line and what exactly they'll be doing, I do suspect it will probably be in that 4-inch or 3¾-inch type scale with a stylized look to them that fits the comics and everything. And when we get more details on that, I'll be sure to share it with you guys, as well as we'll post it up on Toy News International. Tomasi Nations today, they teased some new San Diego Comic-Con exclusives for this coming year. San Diego Comic-Con takes place in July. And as we start to head into June, I suspect we'll hear more and more about, you know, Comic-Con exclusives from various companies and everything. But today, Tomasi Nations, they released some teaser images. So we don't have specific information like prices or anything like that, how many will be made available and such. But it looks like on the Power Ranger front, they're going to be doing two SH figure art Power Ranger figures, the Red Ranger and the Green Ranger. And the big thing about this looks like it's going to have unmasked or unhelmeted head sculpts that you can put on the figure. So definitely that's going to be cool, I think, for many of you Power Ranger fans. I don't know if they're going to do any more or if they're just doing these two. And then also it looks like they're going to be doing a repaint of their Mechazoid. So it's going to be in black and gold colors. Again, I don't have any pricing information on these, so that we'll have to wait and see. They also released some teaser images for Dragon Ball. So these are the same exclusives it looks like that they're going to be doing for their Dragon Ball North America tour. So that's where they're going to be traveling around to certain cities this coming year, basically celebrating Dragon Ball. And they announced these three exclusive SH figure arts figures. So Broly, God SS, and then the one they announced today is Perfect Cell, the Perfect Cell figure. So, you know, again, those look like we're going to be released at both the North American tour and at San Diego Comic-Con. Still don't have any kind of pricing information on those at either event. I imagine they'll be the same price at both events, but I don't have any pricing information. But again, hopefully those details will be released soon. And then also they released some teaser images for some Pacific Rim figures that looks like they're going to be offering at San Diego Comic-Con as well. And when we get more details on all these things, I'll be sure to update you guys. Now, while we're on the subject of teasers, Mezco Toys also released a teaser of their own today. So this is for their Marvel 112 Collective line, and it's a teaser image for their Marvel comic version of Logan. Previously, they did Old Man Logan, plus they've done several Wolverine figures. But now it looks like we're going to get just a young version of Logan based on the comics. And he's going to have his hat and a leather jacket. I don't know what else he'll have. I just, you know, have this one teaser image. So again, when details become available, more images and everything come available for this figure, I'll be sure to let you guys know. Diamond Select Toys announced that they're going to be doing a 4-pack of Marvel Minimates for Ant-Man and the Wasp. So this 4-pack is going to feature Minimates, movie Minimates of Ant-Man and Wasp. And both of those figures will have alternate heads, unhelmeted heads. And then there's also going to be a ghost figure. And then the fourth figure, they are not yet revealing. I guess it's a character that we've not yet seen in the trailers or anything. So it's too spoilers for them to reveal at this time. But that 4-pack will be coming out later this year. And then for my final piece of Marvel news today, Hot Toys last week released official images for their Avengers Infinity War Doctor Strange figure. So this figure is going to be similar to the previous one they did. However, it is going to sport a new head sculpt, which looks pretty good from these images. And then it's going to have a ton of accessories, so a bunch of new magic effect ring type things and a sword, the magic sword that you see him kind of create to fight Thanos, those wrappings that he shoots out of his hands, they're going to have an effect for that. He's going to have the Eye of Agamotto, and that should have the Time Stone in it, and then he's going to have a figure stand. The one other thing he's going to have is a special backdrop. So originally I thought this was going to be actual arms that you could somehow attach to the figure, but in that scene in Infinity War where basically you see all these arms come out and then he creates duplicates of himself to take on Thanos, well, they've created this backdrop with all the arms out there, so I guess you can kind of sit your figure in front of that and then it'll look like he has all the arms behind him, so you can kind of recreate that effect with an illusion. Again, it would have been cooler, even though I guess I don't know practically how they would be able to pull that off. If, you know, somehow they did all, they were able to make all the hands attachable. But as it is, it is kind of a cool, you know, illusion that he's created, which I guess technically the magic trick was probably some kind of illusion as well. So, you know, I guess, you know, in some ways it's actually kind of realistic. Also, the cape looks like the cape can kind of stand on its own. So, you know, you see in the movie where the cape kind of is acting as its own individual personality. And so you can kind of recreate that as well. And then for the final bit of news today, I have some Transformer news I wanted to share with you guys. So this is more preliminary news that actually has not been officially confirmed by Hasbro, but we are getting this information from third parties, some e-tailers like Robot Kingdom, who is a sponsor of ours, and they have essentially announced it looks like Hasbro for Transformers Anniversary is going to be doing a new line of G1 Transformer reissues with the classic packaging. So we've seen this before. They did reissues many years ago as Toys R Us exclusives, and they would come in the old vintage style packaging, which I think is the best Transformer packaging to this day. I don't think they've ever topped the packaging that those original G1 toys came in. So to me, that's really the coolest thing about these toys is just the packaging. And so the first figure looks like it's going to be Hot Rod. I don't know how many figures they're going to be doing. I don't know if these figures will be released as some kind of exclusive here in the United States or if they'll see a general release. And I don't know what pricing here in the United States is going to be on these figures. So those details will probably be coming soon or at the latest, probably during San Diego Comic-Con. But again, it looks like, you know, if you're a fan of the G1 Transformers, and especially with the packaging and everything, it looks like there is going to be a new line of reissues coming, starting with Hot Rod. Okay, so that's it for the news today. Now, some of you have been asking me to bring back the Q&A portion of these news videos, and if you're not familiar, that's where you guys ask me questions in the comments section below. You just put Q&A next to your question, and then in a future news video, I'll read those questions and try and give you my best answer possible. So I will try and bring that back for the next news videos, so please ask your questions below in this one. Just, again, put Q&A next to it. The next news video will probably be at the end of the week. Also, I'd love to hear your thoughts on everything we talked about today, so leave your comments in the comment section below. If you're so inclined, please like the video, and if you haven't already, please subscribe to the channel. I do really appreciate it. Just hit that button down below. You can also follow me on my Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and Twitch accounts. I have links to all those in the video description. And until next time, guys, I will catch you later.